At the Hansen house, Father knows best.
I hit a minor speed bump.
Would that be the gambling speed bump?
I could really use a job, Dad.
You come in every morning and take Joanie's place.
And I'm down with it, because you're the boss.
My name is Heather. Heather Tupperman. And I'm here to temp for Joanie.
Let me show you around.
Joanie should know better.
Brought it in for show and taste.
Since I tried that chowder, I've been thinking about you.
I'd like to market your soup.
Oh.
And I'm just trying to do some good.
Face it, Sid. You've always been a sucker for a stray.
No.
Lilly.
Don't leave me alone, please.
I'm not going anywhere.
Hurry up, Sid. You're going to be late for the meeting.
What meeting?
Here.
Hello, and welcome to the Collective. I'm Michael. What's your name?
Sidney Hansen.
Hello, Sidney Hansen.
Sidney, would you like to make an opening statement?
About what?
Well, perhaps you could tell us what brought you here to Saints Anonymous.
Mother?
They're going to help you quit helping people.
What are you talking about?
The first sign of a problem is...
denial.
I'm not denying anything.
You have it in your head that you have to save this girl, Lilly.
She needs my help.
Oh. Sidney, did she ever ask for it?
Not exactly. She's just a kid.
Kids, lepers, dogs, all the same.
The needy.
All of us were addicted, Sidney, and we'll all be recovering helpers for the rest of our lives. But we don't teach a 12-step process like those other organizations. We take a simpler approach.
What's that?
Just...
stop!
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 Tell me that even angels fall. Sometimes when it's quiet, I can hear you call. When I think of your smile, oh, you make me home. It could be a million miles, and you make me home. The sound of your voice, you make me home.
Morning, Sid.
Morning. Would you like a cappuccino, Dad?
A what?
Coffee.
No, thanks.
Looks like it's time to wake up and hear the coffee.
Yeah, I just got a new cappuccino machine.
Sid, this is Providence, not L.A. We don't make cappuccino at home.
Guess that means you don't want one.
No, I'll have a double.
Morning.
Hey, it's a youngster. What's up?
Oh, I have a big chowder meeting today. Brady said he had some big news.
Good. Maybe he finally realized that he should expand the partnership and include a little romance.
A little something.
Hey, remember Lilly, the girl who went through the glass at the clinic?
Yeah.
I'm releasing her from the hospital today.
Did they ever locate her parents?
No. She was a ward of the state in Oklahoma, so she'll be a ward of the state here.
Yeah, what a life, huh?
Isn't there something you can do, Sid?
I can continue to be her doctor. Other than that, I'm not getting involved.
Oh, really?
Yes. Get used to it. It's the new me. Morning, Lilly.
Morning, Dr. Hansen.
This is Alex Mendoza, Lilly Gallagher.
Hi, Lilly. I'm from the DCYF. That stands for Department
of Children, Youth, and Families.
I know you're not looking forward to all this, Lilly, but it won't be as bad as you think. We've been extremely lucky to have some of our best foster parents, Tom and Elizabeth Gerwin, agree to take you in. Now, they have three of our kids already, and they're all doing amazingly well.
Well, that's a good sign, right? So, Lilly, you have both my numbers. You'll keep in touch, I hope.
So if you're ready, I'll take you back to the group home. We'll process your file, and the Gerwins will pick you up there.
Can I talk to Dr. Hansen before I go?
Sure. I'll be outside.
Dr. Hanson, I was wondering if you'd have some work for me to do.
You mean like a job?
I was thinking that I'd start saving some money so by the time I'm 18, I can move back to Oklahoma and live on my own. And I can work on weekends or after school.
Well, Lily, I'll have to think about that, and I'll get back to you. You okay?
Sure. It's not like I've never been through this before.
I've got the towels.
Hey,
there's nothing like a little teamwork. I thought that I'd help you dry.
Great. Hey, come here.
Spike.
Spike, get back here. Heather, can I get some help, please?
I'm coming.
Heather. Hi.
I'm Dorothy Chenoweth. I'm here to see Dr. Hanson.
He's making a house call.
This is Wolfgang Chenoweth the Fourth.
How's it hanging, Wolfie?
I'm leaving for Mountain Springs Spa, and I will be back tomorrow night. Now, Wolfgang will have the usual. Dr. Hanson will know what to do.
Yeah, sure. We'll treat him like a prince.
Goodbye, Wolfie. Bye-bye. Here. Oh. Very good, very good.
Heather, fill up the tub. We got one more mud to wash.
Helen, do you know where the pediatric encyclopedia is?
Should be over there somewhere.
This place is so disorganized.
You just noticed?
No. You know, actually, it reminds me, I've been thinking, maybe we can get somebody to help out around here.
It's a great idea, if only we had the money to pay them.
Well, maybe we could afford paying one person, you know, on a part-time basis, like a high school student or something.
You have somebody in mind?
Yes. What about Lily?
Sid, I don't know how you can ask me to accept that girl into this clinic after what happened.
Look, I know it sounds crazy.
Is there something you're not telling me?
She reminds me of a girl named Alice Morrow.
Who's Alice Morrow?
My best friend in the fifth grade. Her parents died in a car accident, and she had no other living relatives, so they made her a ward of the state. I begged my mother to let her live with us, but she wouldn't go for it. I remember the day they came to pick her up. There's just, no kid should have to go through that.
Why do you always manage to do this with me? All right, she can work here, but tell her it's only a trial period.
Thank you, Helen. Look, if anything goes wrong, it's my fault.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, Joanie.
Hey.
Wait. Oatmeal cinnamon raisin.
The nose knows.
I do have other talents. Just ask my girlfriend.
Delicious.
Thanks.
So guess who called me this morning?
Famous Amos.
Better, Yamada.
My mother?
No, Henry Yamada, executive VP of American International Foods.
Am I supposed to be impressed?
Very. It's the biggest food conglomerate in New England, and they want to meet you to talk chowder.
No way. I can't believe it. I'm going to be a millionaire. No, I'm going to be a billionaire. Oh, my God. That's so exciting. Oh, no, I'm sorry. Not just me. We are going to be gazillionaires. Remind me to ask Sid how much a new butt would cost.
Can I help you?
Yeah, I'm looking for a girl named Lily Gallagher.
Nobody here by that name. Sorry.
She landed this morning. I think she's inside.
Thank you. Lily.
Dr. Hanson.
Hey.
Hi.
I just wanted to stop by and talk to you before your foster parents came and picked you up.
They're 10 minutes late.
I've got good news.
Okay.
Well, you got the job at the clinic. 2 hours a day on weekdays and 5 hours on Saturdays. Minimum wage.
Great, thanks.
It's on a trial basis, okay?
I won't let you down.
Okay.
Lily?
Oh, hey.
Hi. I'd like you to meet Mr. and Mrs. Gerwin.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
This is Dr. Hansen, who treated Lily after the accident.
Hello.
Hello.
I was just here letting Lily know that she has a job at the clinic if she wants it.
Oh, we're thrilled to have Lily joining our family, but...
We already have her after-school employment worked out for.
Oh, doing what?
We'll discuss it after dinner.
Dr. Hansen, why don't we leave Lily with the Gerwins and let them get acquainted?
Yeah, sure. Okay. Bye.
Bye.
I'm sorry. I should have mentioned this before, but the Gerwins have a retail stationery store, and they like all their fosters to work there. It gives them a chance to monitor them on a full-time basis.
I understand.
But I'd still like you to stay involved.
Sure.
Okay. I better get back and see how they're doing.
Yeah, hey, just let me know how it goes.
Sure. But don't worry, it'll go just fine.
He's right. There'll be one big happy family in no time.
So you're not doing anything? No. Well, I have an appointment around 10 o'clock, but I could probably squeeze you in around midnight, or you could squeeze me. Look, I gotta get back to you about this. Okay,
bye.
Customer, I assume?
Yes.
Working late, are we?
Yes, we are.
It's time for Wolfgang's walk.
Again? That's the third one of the day. How does the old lady do it?
Obsessively. She has a professional dog walker, not to mention dog trainer and dog therapist.
Well, doggone.
Dorothy doesn't have any children, so Wolfgang's kind of a surrogate son.
I wonder how she feels about adoption.
I'll ask. When you get back, you can walk the rest of the guys.
Dad, can I just take them all at once, please?
What, are you kidding? Wolfgang walks alone.
My hip still hurts.
I realize that. It's just like I told you yesterday. You fractured it, and it's still healing.
Well, why can't it heal faster?
You better stop jogging.
Oh?
I'm kidding. It's a joke. Okay, I'm gonna need you to stand up for me so we can start strengthening that hip.
I can do it.
Oh, okay. Well, holler when you're ready.
American International Foods. How may I direct you? Yes, please.
Here she is, folks. Miss Mom's Chowder, Joanie Hansen.
Thank you for taking the time to meet with us, Miss Hansen. Please sit.
Oh, thank you. It's nice to be off the diaper detail.
Joanie's got a little baby, Hannah. Loves Mom's Chowder.
Actually, it made her hurl, but that's because she has a little bug.
Joanie, I think Mr. Yamada might find it fascinating to hear about the genesis of the product.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Actually, it was a fluke. My dad was in bed with the flu, and he was taking care of a blind woman's sick dog. So she ended up helping me cook dinner that night. And so when it came time to add the cream base, she dumped in my breast milk instead.
It was pre-expressed in the refrigerator.
Yeah, hence the name, Mom's Chowder. Get it.
But you're still not using the...
No, we found a terrific substitute.
Truth is, I'm a really lousy cook, but hey, I put the wow in chowder.
Put the wow in chowder.
Well, she's being modest, of course. But don't be alarmed, folks. The current recipe meets all federal health regulations.
There's no wow in chowder.
There is in mine.
I want it!
Tony, you are like a breath of fresh air. Judith, Carl, I'd like you to schedule a testing session as soon as possible.
Yes, sir.
It was a pleasure meeting with you, Joanie. Keep working on those slogans.
Yes,
sir. Thank you.
Oh Lord, it's a dog's life, dog's life. Oh Lord, it's a dog's life. Oh Lord, it's a dog's life, dog's life. I'm feeling
very
angry.
Come here!
Ha! It's bubbling inside me. Shine.
The life I lead is the life of a dog. I may have fleas, but I'm an iron. I am no slave to a suit and a tie. No rat race clone, I'll never be that guy.
Kelly. Oh, man.
man.
I need a beer.
Coming right up.
What's going on? They're getting ready to shoot that TV commercial.
Tomorrow.
Can I have another, please?
Mom said there'd be days like this, huh?
Actually, she forgot to mention the part about psychotic commercial directors. We lost our lead dog, and my director is taking it personally.
Well, I got a trio right here.
Sorry, we need a specific breed.
There you go. Maybe I can help. Happen to have an amazing dog connection.
Yeah?
Yep.
If you can deliver a standard poodle to the director's liking in the next 24 hours, you can make a couple thousand dollars.
Did you say standard poodle?
How old's she gonna be?
19.
I think you're about 6 years too late.
Lily, what are you doing here?
Hold on a minute, please. Dr. Hansen, I'm just getting some inside scoop from a real-life teenager. My niece is gonna turn 19. Okay, so, come on. What do you suggest?
Music. Anything by Beck.
Bach?
No, not Bach. Beck.
Where would I find such a thing?
Any record store. You can order it and pay by phone. If you want, I'll pick it up for you after school tomorrow.
Oh, you are a dear.
I've been called other things.
Me. Sorry about the location, but, Helen's in the office, and this is really the only other place to talk.
I can't believe I took out poor old St. Martin.
Yeah, well, I'm sure he's still with us in spirit. So, what's up? I thought that your parents had other plans for you today.
Please, they're just fosters.
Oh.
They said I didn't have to start till tomorrow, so I figured this was my last chance to stop by.
They know you're here, right?
Oh, yeah. I got a new leash.
Well, they do seem like really nice people, Lily.
Yeah, it's just weird, that's all.
Weird how?
Take two adults, add one teenager, stir. Instant family. No matter how you cut it, they're still strangers.
Yeah, but I'm a stranger too. It seems like we get along really well.
Yeah, that's different.
How?
I robbed you, broke your stained glass window, and bled all over you.
You're right. That's the perfect recipe for a long-lasting friendship.
But you did save my life.
Not that you deserved it.
It's me. Gerwin's calling.
Guess I'm late.
Oh, yeah. That old lady I was talking to.
Willa?
Yeah. Tell her I was serious about picking up that Beck CD for her.
Okay, I will.
Okay, so if Brady's numbers are even close, I'm gonna clear $250,000 next year. So I have to buy a house right away for the deduction, right?
True.
Only I didn't want to move until Hannah was a little bit older. You know what I could do? I could buy this house and rent it back to you guys.
Surely you jest.
Sort of.
There is a simple solution, you know.
What's that?
Move to Connecticut.
Connecticut?
See, as your primary residence, you pay no state tax. You see what I'm saying? Then write off all your expenses in Providence as business.
Wow, that is so cool.
Hey, what's with the boxes?
Oh, I'm just putting together some old clothes for Lily. Hey, Joanie, did you get a chance to go through your closet?
Yeah, I put some stuff on my bed that I thought she'd like.
Great, thanks.
Is that clothes for the kid whose life she wasn't gonna get involved in?
What can I say? The girl can't help it.
Wake up, dear. Michael's here.
Oh, no. Mother, not another one of those meetings.
No, it's just a progress report. He'd like to hear how you're doing with the wayward girl.
It's the middle of the night, for God's sakes.
Resentment. Typical week one reaction.
Okay, if you must know, it has been difficult for me not to help Lily. And I think my mother knows why.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Does the name Alice Morrow ring a bell, Mother?
So that's what this is all about?
What?
What are you doing here? You don't belong in this dream.
I beg your pardon?
She's right. Get lost. If this is some misguided guilt about Alice Morrow, I can only tell you that it was out of your hands. There's nothing you can do about it now.
Maybe not. How do you know that Lily isn't my second chance?
There are no second chances.
Are you gonna get that?
No, it'll go away.
There. Alice?
Hi, Sid. You've really aged well. You too, Mrs. Hansen.
Thanks, dear. She was always so polite.
I just wanted to thank you for your help 20 years ago.
I didn't do anything.
Oh, yes, you did. You You tried to keep me from going to a foster home. You threw yourself in front of the dorm when they came to take me away.
I'm sorry I didn't do any good.
We were kids. And kids just don't have a say in anything really important.
Some things never change.
Well, you're not a kid anymore, Sid. You have the power to help Lily.
Thank you for sharing that, Alice.
I cannot go back there. Please don't make me.
Oh, come on in.
Pancakes. What's a big occasion? Somebody getting married?
No, we're having a guest for breakfast.
Who?
That homeless kid Lily showed up on our doorstep last night. Sid took her in.
Sid, what a Samaritan. Well, great, I guess.
What's great? Oh, pancakes. Somebody getting married?
We're hosting a street urchin courtesy of St. Sid.
It's that kid that flew through the clinic window during the drug heist.
You're kidding.
Morning, guys. I wanted you to meet Lily.
You're not
She's
kidding.
She's a patient of mine who needed a place to stay, so she bunked with me last night.
Hi, Lily. I'm the dad.
Hi.
And you know Joanie, my sister.
Hi.
And that's Robbie, my brother.
Hi, Robbie.
You like flapjacks, Lil?
Sure.
Normally, we eat gruel for breakfast, unless, of course, Joanie's announcing one of her weddings.
Ha ha! Robbie's practicing to be the family comedian. We're waiting for him sometime in the near future to actually say something funny.
I'm thinking.
Hey, Lily. Did you get enough to eat?
Yeah. I usually just have coffee and a smoke.
Yum. I wanted to let you know that I called Alex Mendoza last night to let him know you were here.
What'd he say?
Well, I got his answering machine, but it was important that he knew you were safe.
It's just gonna complicate things. The girl ones are gonna take it personally. Foster parents always do.
Okay, wait a second. Do you still have a problem going there?
No, it's... I always have a problem my first night. I'll be fine.
All right, well, just take it easy, you know, one day at a time.
All right.
Come on, I gotta get you to school.
Okay. Can I ask you a big favor?
Sure.
I was supposed to get a weekly lunch allowance.
How much do you need?
I don't know.
Look, why don't you take 20? Should cover the next few days.
Thanks.
Okay, keep it down a little bit. We don't want it yet.
Can I bring the other one in?
Yeah, you want a rebel to hung up there?
We're ready for our close-up.
Oh, Robbie, I'm glad you're here. We have some paperwork to get through before we can start shooting.
Paperwork?
Yeah.
What kind?
Just the normal stuff, IRS forms, accident waiver, owner's waiver.
Waiver?
Yeah, so that we can show that we have permission from the owner to use the dog.
That's gonna be a little tricky.
Why is that?
Well, my Aunt Dorothy owns a dog, but she isn't really able to sign her name.
Oh.
She had a stroke. So I'm basically taking care of Wolfie now.
I'm so sorry.
Yeah, well, it's tragic, you know? I mean, the poor mutt just cries for her every night, you know? And I take her over to the home where she's at every week. But she's almost got her petting hand back.
I don't guess we can call her then.
It's probably not a great idea. I mean, see, after the last stroke, she kind of went nocturnal. So she sleeps in the day. But it should probably be awake by sunset.
That's too late. I'll just vouch for you.
Okay. It'll be our little secret.
Oh, Mr. Mendoza.
Thanks for calling.
No problem. I guess the Gerwins probably hate me, huh?
They were understandably upset when they heard Lily ran to your place, but I think now they understand the problem transcends you.
Transcends me?
I just got a call from school. Lily never showed up.
That's not possible. I dropped her off myself.
She stayed just long enough to write this. It was found under the principal's door.
Sorry for your trouble and thanks for all the help, particularly Dr. Hansen. Don't bother to look for me. I won't be coming back.
Pretty determined kid.
Any idea where she might be?
Probably hitching her way out of town.
What makes you say that?
How else is she gonna get around? It's not like she had any money.
Fresh clams are key, but my mom always said if you can't find them fresh, crack open a can and boil them twice.
I feel like I'm on my own cooking show.
And now we're gonna throw in the cayenne pepper. Bam!
She's fantastic,
isn't she?
That was so much fun.
You're right, hit. Now let's see what our focus group has to say.
Delicious.
She can cook and she's hilarious.
What did she just say?
Oh, I speak very little Japanese, but I think she said to put the wow in chow.
I need you all to stand by, people.
Hey, Andrea. How's it going?
Fabulous. We're just about to wrap. Wolfgang was a real pro.
Look, I hate to ask you about this, but...
$2,000? Oh. Don't spend it all in one place.
Thanks. Actually, I was hoping that I could spend some of it on you.
Me?
Yeah. Figured I could take you out to dinner and celebrate our relationship.
Our what?
Well, with my canine connections, I could be very helpful for you, you know?
Right. Listen, I'm busy tonight, so why don't you leave your phone number, and the next time I need a dog, I'll give you a ring.
Okay, people, that's a wrap.
Are you sure that you...
Oh, look, it's a wrap. So why don't you get a blanket for Wolfgang?
Blanket for what?
Well, you're going to take him outside, aren't you?
Yeah.
Usually takes them a couple hours to get used to the haircut.
Haircut? What haircut? Oh, my God. You shaved the dog naked. You shaved the dog naked?
Right, it's in the release you signed.
Where?
On page 4. Wolfgang's our before and after dog, showing the negative effects of not drinking hair of the dog. You did read it, didn't you?
I don't believe this.
Actually, it's perfect timing.
What?
It should take about 6 or 7 weeks to grow back. That should be enough time for Aunt Dorothy to recover from her stroke.
You? What is that?
Finest champagne money can buy. Courtesy of American International Foods.
What for?
Sealing the deal to market your chowder.
Oh my gosh, you're kidding me!
No, we sign the papers tomorrow, then they cut us our first check.
Oh my God, I can't believe this is happening!
It's pretty wild, huh? Hope your passport's current.
Current? I don't even have one.
It's all right, we'll go down to the federal building in the morning and get it.
What do I need a passport for?
Well, Japan, what else?
I'm going to Japan?
Yeah, that's the key to the deal. You're going on a national bus tour promoting the chowder.
Oh, wow.
But don't worry, you're only gonna be traveling for 6 months, and they're gonna put you up in a nice apartment in the heart of Tokyo.
The heart of Tokyo?
Yeah, the mother of all chowders.
Dad?
Hi, Sid. Home for lunch?
No, the DCYF called. Lily's missing.
Well, I can't say I'm surprised.
Really?
No, all morning I kept wondering what she must be thinking. What it must be like to spend a few hours in our home, sleep in a cozy bed, have a family breakfast, only to be shipped off again to God knows where.
Yeah.
It's like when you find a stray dog that doesn't connect to humans. You know he's gonna run the minute he gets a chance.
So what's the answer? Don't do anything? Don't help at all?
I wish I knew.
Do you remember Alice Morrow?
Sure. The little girl whose parents were killed in the car accident.
Yeah, I remember begging Mom to adopt her.
Well, he talked long and hard about that one. In the end, I think it was just fear.
Of what?
The unknown. How it would affect the family, the rest of you kids.
I often wonder what happened to her.
Me too.
It was such a hard day. Watching them take her away, I felt so helpless. I vowed that when I became a grown-up, I would never let something like that happen.
And now that you're a grown-up, you feel just as helpless?
No. I feel a lot worse.
American International Foods has decided to distribute my chowder.
That's great.
Yeah, except for the fact that they want me to move to Japan for a minimum of 3 years.
Ah, so the only question is who gets your room?
Oh, come on, Sid.
Remember, take these with meals, okay? So, Jenny, do you want to move to Japan or not?
Well, no, of course not.
Then what's the problem?
Well, I want them to market my soup.
Well, then move to Tokyo. Okay, look, Joanie, the problem is not the decision. Obviously, you've made the decision. You don't want to go to Tokyo. it's acting on that decision.
What do you mean?
Telling Brady that you're not going.
Well, I'm afraid if I don't go, then it's going to kill the partnership and I'm never going to see him again.
It's not like you'd see him again if you moved to Tokyo, unless he was planning on moving there with you. Think about it.
Dr. Hansen, there's a phone call. It's the police department.
Oh. Hello, Dr. Hansen.
Dad? Dad?
Hey, Robbie. Your dad left about a half an hour ago.
Great.
Robbie?
I didn't do anything. You see, it was like a misunderstanding. We'll call creative differences.
Well, I think we can count on Mrs. Chenoweth for a major freakout. Although, it does bring out the brown in his eyes.
Heather. Heather? If my dad finds out about this, I'm dead. He's gonna neuter me.
What do you want me to do?
Can we say that you spilled some kind of acid on him accidentally?
You want me to take the fall? I'm already on probation.
Okay, right. Okay, well, what if we shave all the animals and then we say that an airborne virus snuck in through the ventilation duct?
No, it's too Hollywood.
Maybe I should just come clean and throw myself on his mercy, huh?
Well, that's brave.
Oh, that's stupid. What the hell am I thinking?
Oh, maybe you could tell your father that you thought Wolfgang had ringworm, so you shaved him.
Oh, that's great! I owe you big time. Great. Thank you so much. And believe me, if this had anything to do with me making some kind of money, I'd definitely cut you in for a piece of the act.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
No, I don't. Alex.
Hi, Sid.
Hi.
Thanks for coming. We're trying to get a sketch of Lily to distribute to missing persons.
No one has a photograph?
Amazingly enough, no. I contacted the state agency in Oklahoma, but they couldn't locate one.
Well, I hope I can help.
Personally, I think you've helped enough.
Betty.
You know why she ran, don't you? She was angry we wouldn't let her take that job you offered her.
Well, I was just trying to help
her. We agreed to be her parents. We are the ones she needed to bond with.
It's no time to be arguing about this. We need to put our energies into finding Lily. So what do you think, Sid?
Excuse me, can I take a look? Her mouth is slightly wider, and cheeks are less round, and eyebrows are definitely thicker.
She's a plastic surgeon.
Dad.
All right, Rob, what's up?
Nothing special. Have you seen Heather run?
No, I missed her, but she left a note saying she was out walking Wolfgang.
Ah. Do you know where?
Dog park, I assume. You know Miss Chenoweth. If Wolfie doesn't get his 5 runs a day, she considers it animal abuse. Oh, my God.
There's an explanation for that.
Yeah. Ringworm.
Ringworm?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, see, when I took him out for his walk earlier, I ran into this guy with this really hot female poodle, Fifi.
Fifi.
Oh, yeah, and Wolfie wants to play. You know, what can I do? Wasn't until later that I realized that Fifi was recovering from ringworm, and, yeah, I just freaked.
And instead of bringing him in here for my professional opinion, you took it upon yourself to shave him.
More or less.
More or less? Rob, that is more or less the biggest crock of bull you've ever delivered. When and if you decide to tell the truth, you give me a holler.
Well, that didn't go really well, did it?
No.
Hey.
Hi.
Sorry I'm late. Your mother called just as I was leaving. Let's take us to dinner tonight to seal the deal.
Look, Brady, I've been giving this whole thing a lot of thought.
What's to think about? This is what we want, right?
Yes, it is. Except for the little part about living in Japan.
Yeah, I know it's gonna be rough at first.
But you're gonna be there to help me with the transition, right?
Well, to be perfectly honest with you, I hadn't really thought that part out.
Well, I have. I was thinking that if you were, you know, not there for a long time, maybe just the first year or so.
A year?
Well, yeah, I'm going to have the baby. I'm going to be working 80 hours a week. I'm not going to know anybody. And if you're there to support me, I really think I can do it.
This isn't going to work, is it?
No. It isn't. Brady, I'm very grateful to you for all the work you've done, and I know how hard it must be to turn down this humongous offer. But I completely understand if you want to go with another partner.
Mm-hmm. So that's it, huh? We blow one lousy multi-million dollar deal, and you want to dissolve the partnership.
Well,
I thought you were in this for the long haul, Joanie. You know, richer or poorer, good business climate or bad.
You want to stay together?
Joanie, this whole deal has only made me want to be in business with you even more. I love your honesty and your strength and your conviction.
You do?
I do. I mean, who else would be foolish enough to turn down a deal like this? And I guess I'm just foolish enough to stick with you.
Finding her?
Oh, no. Police put out a sketch. So there's not much they can do now, but wait.
Where do you think she's headed?
You know, she said she was going to save her money so she could go back to Oklahoma, but she's only got 20 bucks.
You ever run away?
Once. I got as far as the neighbor's backyard. How about you?
Once, but I had a real plan. I took the bus. You can go a lot farther on the money.
Yeah, the police said they checked the bus station.
Well, if you're smart, you don't go to the one downtown. You go to one out of town. Cranston, Pawtucket, Centerdale.
Heather? Is Heather gone?
Yeah, I sent her home.
Can you give me a hand in the back?
Hey, can it wait a sec? Mrs. Chenoweth is going to be here any minute to pick up Wolfgang. I kind of want to handle this.
It's all yours. Oh, while your ringworm routine had some ingenious elements, it might help you to know that I treated him for it earlier this year. Take a look. Maybe you can come up with some more exotic disease.
Thanks, Dad.
Good afternoon. Is Wolfgang ready?
Yeah, Mrs. Chenoweth, he's out back. Before I bring him up, I'd like to warn you about his appearance.
What?
He's been shaved.
Shaved? What on earth for?
Well, to be perfectly honest with you, I put him in a TV commercial for Hair of the Dog beer. You might actually see some of their spots. They're pretty cute. They got these little mutts all gathered around the local pub.
Is this your idea of some kind of joke?
Well, it was...
No, it's true, Mrs. Chenoweth. We just felt it was something that we had to do.
What are you talking about?
Well, you see, these commercial people are always after me to find a dog with just that special quality, and I've never been able to fill the bill. It was Robbie here who recognized Wolfie's true potential.
But yeah, he's on his way to true stardom.
Just think of it, he'll be a national spokes dog. He'll be seen and admired by 20 million people a day.
Not to mention other canines.
Oh. He will no longer be our little secret. Wolfie will be an immortal.
My Wolfie.
You're a Wolfie.
Mr. Edmondson, please report to the ticket desk. Mr. Edmondson, please report to the ticket desk.
Excuse me. You haven't by any chance seen a young girl, about 16, sandy blonde hair, 5'5"?
Not that I've noticed.
How much would it cost to get a ticket to Tulsa?
Round trip?
No, one way.
$129, or I can give you a $59 special with a 10-day advance purchase.
All right, let's just say I wanted to cross the state line.
Well, bus to Hartford leaves in about 20 minutes, $19.
Anywhere else I can go out of state for $20?
Bridgeport, New Haven, Boston, but they've all left. Hartford's your last chance to escape Rhode Island.
Okay, thanks.
You bet.
Hey, Dad. Yeah, I've been to 3 stations in the last 2 hours and not a trace. I know. Yeah, I'm gonna hang around for this last bus and then I'll come back. Thanks.
Hi, Rob.
Hey.
Want some radioactive ravioli?
No, thanks. I'll eat at the bar. Listen, Dad, I wanted to let you know how much I appreciate what you did earlier. For a minute there, you're gonna throw me to the dog owners.
Well, to be honest, I was prepared to let you twist in the wind. But when you hit Mrs. Chenoweth with the unvarnished truth, I couldn't resist. You made me proud.
Oh, thanks, Dad. Hey, listen, now that we're over this little bump, can I borrow the car?
You're serious?
Yeah.
What happened to that four-wheeler O'Neill's let you use?
Well, there is no company car. That was a blatant lie. See, what happened was I borrowed the car from this girl that I met at the bar, but then I had this little fender bender with her boyfriend.
Rob, let's not go overboard with this truth business.
Look at Uncle.
Hi, Joanie. How was your day?
Ah, wild. Went from future millionaire to pauper all in an afternoon.
Really?
Yeah. Long story. Went into a complete tailspin, but Sid pulled me out. Huh. Where is she, anyway?
At the Pawtucket bus station, waiting for the last bus to Hartford.
Huh.
Care for some ravioli?
Sure.
At least had enough influence to get you to quit.
Old habits die hard.
Yeah, it doesn't mean you can't change them. There's support groups for everything these days.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Even for doctors who don't know when to mind their own business.
I had nothing to do with you. I just couldn't face that whole thing.
You can't run away from this, Lily. I mean, there's no magical place to return to. The only real place is inside. And you have to change that enough so that you feel comfortable living there. I'm not saying it's easy, but at least you'll have one person rooting for you. That's half the battle. The other half is just figuring out a way to get you to quit smoking. What do you say we get out of here? Hartford's a nice place, but it can't compete with Providence. Come on.
In a meeting.